Welcome back to Logitech. I know a lot of people curious about this new Intel Cooler processor, the Intel Black Cooler. This cooler looks very cool compared to the previous cooler. This cooler comes for Intel 11th Gen and 10th Gen. However, for the 10th Gen, this cooler only comes for Core i7 above or the latest Core i3-10105F. The other processor only comes with the older cooler, this one, the Intel stock cooler. Yeah, this one is the ancient cooler. It's already used since the Intel Core first gen and end up until the Intel 10th gen. For Core i5 and the Core i3 10th gen, they still using this white cooler except the 10105F. I also will compare this cooler performance with this budget CPU cooler, Cooler Master Hyper H 410R. This cooler is quite cheap, it only costs at 19 bucks. So you don't need to worry about adding extra cost to buy extra cooler. Okay, let's test the performance of this new Intel cooler now. I'm going to test it with Cinebench R23. Firstly, we test it at the stock TDP 65W. Room temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. The old stock cooler running at 31 to 3200 MHz and the temperature is 67 degrees Celsius. While the black cooler running around 32 to 3300 MHz and the temperature is at 65 degrees Celsius. The Cooler Master Hyper 410R running at the same 32 to 3300 MHz but the temperature is only 53 degrees Celsius. Moving next to 80 watt limit. We see the old cooler running at 35 to 3600 MHz. And the temperature is at 73 degrees Celsius. The new Intel Black Cooler running stable at 3600 MHz and the temperature is at 71 degrees Celsius. The Cooler Master running around 36 to 3700 MHz and the temperature is much different, around 57 degrees Celsius only. Next is a 100 watt test. The old cooler running around 38 to 3900 MHz and the temperature is at 83 degrees Celsius. While the new cooler running around 39 to 4000 MHz and the temperature is at 80 degrees Celsius. Cooler Master stable at 4000 MHz and the temperature only 62 degrees Celsius. The last one, we test it at 125 watt limit. In this test, 11400F reached 130 watt maximum with the old stock cooler. It will hit 100 degrees Celsius for a while, then it will go back to 125 watt setting and running at 98 degrees Celsius. The clock running around 41 to 4200 MHz. The new black cooler will reach at 126 watt at the maximum. The wattage will drop by 1 watt to 125 watt. And the clock still stable at 4200 MHz. At 126 watt, the temperature will hit 96 degrees Celsius and after go back to 125 watt, the temperature will only hit at 94 degrees Celsius. Well, at least there is no throttling here. 11400F only running at maximum 114 watt with this Cooler Master cooler. The clock running at 4200 MHz stable and the temperature is only 67 degree at maximum. It's a nice job for 19 bucks cooler. Based on our test just now, this Intel stock coolers still can manage to handle the Core i5-11400F until 125 watt without any throttling. compared to this older cooler, this cooler will throttle when you test it with 11400F. Yeah, it's around 100 MHz throttle and it will the temperature will hike to 99 to 100 Celsius. Well, this one is managed to handle it to 95 degrees Celsius. However, I don't recommend you to use it until 125 watt. Maybe it's around 100 watt. It also depends on the ambient. The ambient I test is around 26 to 27 degrees Celsius, so it's also based on your PC case, airflow and ambient inside it. If the ambient is good enough, yeah, you can use it up to 100 watt maybe. But if not really good, I think maybe you can only just use it up to 80 watt. Yeah, I think 80 watt is good enough. Comparing to this HyperEdge 410R, this cooler is very good. It can handle 11400F better than DOS cooler. Even though it's only 19 bucks, it managed to stop Core i5 11400F from throttle and it's only around 70 degrees Celsius the maximum. So yeah, that's all from me for the test. So if you still want to use this cooler, I suggest you to only use it until 80 watt. For 100 watt, yeah, it depends on your case lah. Okay, I hope you like this video. Please subscribe and thanks for watching.